warned you about this DJ. Your mama approves of him.
This DJ is official.
Push the culture.
Straight for the culture. I'll never get it twisted. You feel me?
Push the culture.
Sticks and stones break bones, but words are never heard. Shit. Whoever said that never stood in front of one of these verses. The Soul City, aka that sick dude Vic Rude, and I'm pushing the culture with my man Push the Culture right here on BIGOLive. You did.
Push the culture.
He's official.
Yo, what up? This Curtis Cope coming live through your speakers with my brother, my Ace Boom Coon, my Bison, my man Culture. Bringing you that raw shit straight for the culture. Don't ever get it twisted, you feel me? Straight on BIGOLive. For real!
Hey, it's your favorite cousin, Queen Suga. You are now tuned in to one of the dopest podcasts to ever hit your eardrum.
Push the culture.
We ride together, we fly together, baby. What's understood don't need to be said, so let's push the button in.
Push the culture.
It's your man's DJ Backspin, representing for my G Push. And just know, we push the culture.
Straight on BIGOLive.
All right, let's get it going. Let's get it going. Thanks, everybody, for tapping in and tuning in with us, man. This is your man, Push, alongside the phenomenal
Queen Suga.
Yes, and we are back with another edition of Push the Culture podcast. We are broadcasting live on BIGOLive. So big shout out to everybody that's tapped in and tuning into the podcast live. Shout yourselves out.
Shout it out. Shout it out. I like that shirt, man.
Listen here. Good. Listen, you the one made me go bust it out the bag. Good. I wasn't going to bust mine out the bag yet, you know what I'm saying? But then you stepped out in your joint. I said, once again, big shout out to kingcode.com. They keep the fresh just fresh. So make sure, you know what I mean? Y'all hollering at kingcode.com. KYNGCODE.com.
Jip, dip, thank you for those exclusive gifts.
Oh, yes, thank you. Big shout out to all our BIGO folk them in the building. All right. It has been a while. September 1st, of the month, 2021.
It's Virgo, you know what I mean? Season.
Right. So, first, in case this is your first time over here with us at Push the Culture Podcast, you know, just so you understand, a lot of people, when they first come or they first time they hear the name, they say, What culture? I say, Push the Culture. What culture? Now, I must say, respectfully, if that is your first question, this is probably not for you. Okay? So what's understood don't need to be said, you know, first and all. But we are here to make sure that we protect the culture and inject positive images and messages of the culture to the culture. All right? Directly from the culture. So that's what we're here to do. All right, by any means necessary. We're going to get in a few things. First of all, I want to go into, I want to send some prayers out. Had a crazy hurricane going on in Louisiana, so we want to make sure we send our prayers out to everybody down there right now. You know, if you got family, loved ones down there, you know what I mean? If there's anything you could do to help them out, make sure y'all do that. It's very important.
Yes, prayers goes out to everyone in Louisiana. We know that there's been a lot of damage. They compare it to Katrina. Some say that it was worse than Katrina. Some say it's the same as Katrina, but regardless of, they weren't prepared. The infrastructure wasn't prepared for the 300 thousands of people that is who's lost their power right now. It's the temperatures is in the 80s and into the hundreds. The heat index is high, you know. Water is something very important, which they need a lot of water. The governor, which one is it? Governor is asking people to not come back right now. It says the infrastructure is not in place to help. Yeah, so if you have family, I hope that you have contacted them. Try to keep in contact. We have some BIGO family that I hope we do get to see.
Our hopes and prayers go out to them. And, but on a brighter note, speaking on Louisiana, big shout out to Baton Rouge and Boosie and Boosie Bash. Oh, wee. Boy, I said they did the damn thing out there, Boosie Bash, it. Man. Yeah, they did that. They did that. Yes, they did.
They did it.
Two major, it was ridiculous amount of performances. Everybody from Webby came back, you know what I'm saying? Webby performed and everything with Boosie. That was crazy. But there were really two performances that stood out to me the most out of the event. First of all was Little Baby coming through and doing what he did. Little Baby came through. He did the show on the strength. If y'all don't know what I mean when I say he did it on the strength, Little Baby did the show on the strength, okay? He did not charge Boosie to do the show, you know what I mean? And Little Baby's getting close to 400,000 a show right now. So big shout out to Little Baby for, you know what I'm saying, coming through. That's something that Boosie does for the neighborhood, for the community, for the culture, you know what I'm saying? So big shout out to Boosie for that, you know what I mean, for holding Boosie Bass despite what be going on out here. Big shout out to Boosie for that. And then double back, big shout out for Lil Baby pulling up, you know what I'm saying, and just keeping it real with the people like that, you know what I mean. So big shout out to them on that. But.
There's a but. What?
I gotta say, my man stole the show. Okay? They had my man on the bench all summer. Okay? It was acting like they, you know what I'm saying? They didn't know what they was missing. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
But The baby? The baby came back crazy.
All right, now.
The live show killer. All
right, now.
Man, listen here. I said, my man, listen, if you had the baby booked for one of your festivals this year and, you know, for the reasons, and you ended up taking him off of your festival card, man, he made you regret not getting his performance at your festival this year.
Word.
That man told, he performed everywhere at Boosie Bash but the stage.
It was one of those. Babe, I didn't get to see it. I'm talking about those, like that.
You're going to see some of the highlights on the, you know what I mean? Make sure you watch the Push the Culture YouTube version, and you will be seeing some of the highlights of this as I'm talking my shit. Yo, my man was everywhere. I'm talking about standing on the guardrail.
On the guardrail.
Standing on the guardrail, rocking the guardrail.
Standing on the guardrail.
And right in front of the stage. No, I'm talking about the guardrail in the middle of the crowd.
Oh, he was out there with the people.
Listen, the whole show was in the crowd. Then he leaves from there. He goes up to the bleachers. He's in the stands with it.
Performer.
The baby.
Yeah.
Glad to see my man back in rotation. You know what I'm saying? Word. Make sure y'all keep supporting the baby. You dig what I'm saying?
We all
make, you know what I'm saying, mistakes. You know what I'm saying? Word. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we human. You know what I mean? Like, word. Sometimes we say things and it ain't got nothing to do with nobody else. You know, we're just speaking. You know? So sometimes it's not everything is meant to offend somebody. So, you know, the second that you don't realize you offend somebody and then you apologize for it, you have to take that apology sincerely
and move on.
So, big shout out.
Big shout out to the baby.
Yeah.
Big shout out to Boosie.
Yeah. Boosie Bash, like that. So, big shout out to them on that. Then, I got to talk about this Kanye West album. Donda has finally released. Finally out.
Uh-oh. Oh, Kanye. Yeah, Kanye. What you think about it?
Listen, I have to. You have to look at this album completely different. This might be one of the most futuristic musical projects ever put together.
It's a Kanye back, basically.
This is a different type of Kanye. I'm going to be honest with you. The way that this album is set up and it's formatted, okay, is set up for Broadway.
The album is set up for Broadway.
Explain for a Broadway that. Musical.
Okay.
Okay. Now, there's a lot of elements to this album that people initially might listen to it and you're not going to get it. This album will not be enjoyable for me personally until I get the stem player for the album.
What's the stem player?
Okay. Now, this is the catch. This is why I say this might be one of the most amazing, phenomenal musical projects of all time. What Kanye did with this album is he created a stem player for this. What a stem player is, for those that aren't really and you know, musically engineered inclined, the word stem doesn't mean anything to you. But what it is, it's a player that allows you to customize all the songs. When I say customize all the songs, this means that you can bring in the bass line, you can take out the bass line, you can add the auto tune, take out the auto tune, you can remix. Look, the Queen Suga, who's a DJ, like, this is...
That is dope.
The reason it is such a genius move is because what happens with that stem player, this album can literally be played over a million different ways.
That's
if not
dope.
More than that.
That's dope.
You know, you could actually, there could be copies of the album that can never be recreated. Like, you could redo the album completely the way you want it.
That's dope.
So this, the
that's futuristic.
This is beyond futuristic. You know what I mean? So that's why I said Kanye. And like, the way that the album is formatted, if you just put it in, you have to, this is an album that you need visual for. Just listening to it raw. Because first of all, I guess Universal put the album out. Kanye didn't want the album out yet. They already made close to about $12 million just holding the album back for the last few weeks. Oh. So, but you know, maybe Universal will, for whatever reason, they go ahead and drop the album. But the way that the album is, when you listen to it right off of the jump, it's like you really need to see something going on, because it's a lot of melody. It's extremely musical.
Okay.
It's extremely musical. A lot of instrumentation. Not a lot of really like vocals and things. You know, there's...
So you get to put that in with the stem?
Yeah, with the stem player.
You do all of that with the...
You can play it however you want to play it with the stem player.
Oh.
Like some of the songs, like they have a real slow build up, right? But with the stem player, you could go ahead and drop the bass line as soon as it comes. Boom, and go crazy. You know what I'm saying? So... I'm looking forward, you know, to listening to it on the stem player.
Yeah, me too.
But the way he did it with the rollout, the show in Chicago, where you know they took the stadium, reconstructed his childhood home.
Oh wow!
You know, set himself on fire. That whole presentation is what lets me know that this is more of a Broadway type of angle that he's putting on it, and I'm looking forward to seeing it.
So you get away from Oh girl, look at.
She's not really gone.
Wait, what you mean she's not really gone?
All right. At the Chicago show, a part of the show was him and Kim getting married at the show.
Oh, he put that in. Oh,
yeah. Yeah, I think there is a song to her on the album too, or something like that. And they're apparently working things out.
Oh God!
You know, they're working things out.
You know, I mean, you know.
It's marketing. Hey. It's marketing. They're perfect for each other. You know, it was marketing. They were ending the Keeping Up with the Kardashians show. Mm-hmm. Okay, that show was coming off of the air, so that was part of, I believe, part of the incentive. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. For them to do that, mm-hmm. with the Keeping Up with the Kardashians. So you know they needed the drama for that, and then of course you see Ye doubling back now to go and drop this album. So collectively, you know, it makes sense. It's a Kardashian-ish move.
All right. Well then, Well. Either way, congratulations to Kanye for that move, you know. I mean, I'm all about, you know, marriages lasting, you know, even though I don't care for her, but, you know.
It is what it is.
It is what it is, you know. We not married. You know, I ain't married to her, so, hey. Yeah,
you know. That part. Yeesh. Yeah. All right. So.
Moving on.
I'm about to come for them. Boy. I'm coming for them real quick. You know how I do.
What you about to do?
About that time.
What?
It is about that time.
It's about that time.
It's about that time.
It's about that time.
I'm not about to play with you right now.
Somebody out of pocket. Who out of pocket?
Definitely, definitely. Listen, now, this is an out of pocket. You know what? I gotta say. All right, okay. This is how I'm gonna phrase this out of pocket. Okay, because it's an out of pocket without an address. You understand? Like it's a pocket with no pants at this time. Currently, it's a pocket with no pants. I say it's a pocket with no pants because I don't know where to issue the blame.
Oh, you don't know who to blame? Okay.
I don't know who to put
somebody
the blame
out of pocket.
There. Yes. Who the hell started the crate challenge? I'm watching the crate challenge. First of all, where the hell y'all get all these damn crates from? Respectfully.
I would like to know, respectfully. Respectfully. Where? Respectfully. Now, there's a lot of damn crates. Yo, but we are some resourceful people, so I mean.
Damn that.
No, for real though.
I done seen people almost kill themselves. Like, listen.
Come on now. I'm out here doing the hood Olympics with no life insurance in the hood. I'm out here climbing crates. It's gonna be cradle to the grave. I'm finna check out. This shit hurt.
And where are y'all getting all these fucking crates, crate monster.
I thought climbing crates was gonna be simple till I fell off and that sharp corner hit me in the temple. Who dropped off these crates? Then we climbing crates like it's something at the top other than a hospital bill. I'm out here bleeding like a goofball. Then I brought my own crate like I was going to hoop.
Get me to some ice cube.
Big fella, don't climb no more crates. Go climb in bed. You have to.
Let me try that motherfucker one more time.
I should have probably just pushed up
out of here. Challenge. Listen, I thought, listen, I don't want it to be true because I just gave Boosie all these big props. But Boosie, if I find out you started that in the Hood Olympics, if that was you started that, boy, I'm telling you, we got to talk. Yeah, yeah, Boosie had the Hood Olympics before Boosie Bash, you know what I'm saying? So,
oh. Yeah.
But that's what, you know, that's one of the first places I saw the crate challenge, but I don't want to put that on my guy right now, you know what I'm saying? Respectfully.
Respectfully.
You know, respectfully, you know.
Yo, because them falls be looking like it hurt.
But I've also seen some stunts, too. I've seen the dude go all the way up the joint, the tall one, rolling the whole blunt. Roll the whole blunt. You know what I'm saying? On his way down, stop, lit that thing.
Oh, so he made it. He was one of the ones that made it.
Yeah, it was a few. It's a few. It's a few success stories. Not as funny as the fails.
Yeah, I've seen the falls.
Yeah, never.
People
never.
Kicking it.
So, matter of fact, we're actually going to go into that segment, you know what I mean? So, big shout out to Ha Ha Davis for some of them clips that we just saw. Yeah, that's, you know, big shout out to Ha Ha Davis. He is my guy. Make sure y'all follow Ha Ha Davis.
I have something. I don't know if it's an out of a pocket or if it's like a what the fuck.
You didn't have a.
Yeah. I don't know if it's out of pocket. And it's not here. Okay, thankfully, when I was reading the story, it's not anyone from here in the States, but it was a young man, about 25 years old. Him and his fiance, you know, they wanted to hook up, you know, they wanted to have sex, but they didn't want to have no children. Okay, so for protection, they didn't have a condom. For protection. Instead of using a condom, because they didn't have any, they used, you know, the closest thing that they had or that they thought they had, which was glue.
Straight for the culture. I'll never get it twisted.
Use glue. Oh, no. Babe. That's all I'm saying. Where did they get A? He used glue. Yeah.
All right. So after all, they like glue been around for a long time.
Yeah, glue been around for a long. Right. Long time.
Glue been around for a long time. Mm-hmm. Like glue didn't just come out yesterday and was
sure
like, well, damn, I wonder all the things that glue is capable of doing. You know what I'm saying? Like you know, I want to test the strengths and the you know, the efficiency of the glue.
Of the glue,
yeah,
right.
Yeah, because, you know, they acting like this thing is, you know, so wonderful and amazing.
Right.
But we've been hip to glue for a long time. We got so many different variations of the glue now. It, you know, you get glue for days.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I thought, old girl, all right? Now, old girl with the Gorilla glue
on her hair.
She
right.
was she was the don of the glue shit.
Right.
Okay? She ran the glue trilogy. Yeah. She was in the number one glue fail in history. You understand?
In the history.
Now, it's a little bit different because she was able to show her failure on the camera and things like that. You feel me?
Right.
My man. He ain't got nowhere to even sell the shit. You dig what I'm saying? Because there ain't no OnlyFans, it's gone. No. You can't even flash the thing on OnlyFans.
No.
You know what I'm saying? Because I'm pretty sure he'd get a couple dollars right now, man, because motherfucker want to see what that looked like. You know what I mean?
Glued together.
Yeah. Yeah.
Penis.
Yeah. No, my man pull-out game was weak. Shit.
Right?
Yeah, my man, his pull-out game was weak, man. God dang. Baby, I'm going to need you. Yeah, give me a little handy. Give me a little handyman for the night. You know what I'm saying? We ain't going there. I'm sorry. I'll be damned. Shit. We're just going to have to handle it on the back end. So, yeah, my man right there. yeah, I guess I can't give you nothing else. You know what I mean? But you definitely get one of these.
Is that an Outta Pocket?
Part of using glue. God damn. You really ain't want to have no baby.
Yo, that's, yeah. Yeah. That's when you
really
know.
Didn't want to have no baby. Jeez.
Shit, motherfuckers is, you know, you would have thought we was in the zombie apocalypse or something.
Well, damn.
Whoa. I'm just saying, you would have thought. You know what, Queen Sugar King? Okay. Oh, that's right. All right, all right. Okay. Whoop. Let me make sure I do this before we get any further along in the festivities. Yo, we want to thank everybody that's tuning in with us to the broadcast on many different platforms. Big shout out to BIGOLive, all the listeners on Spotify, Anchor.fm, Google Podcasts, Breaker Podcasts, Pocket Cast, Radio Public, and also everybody watching on YouTube. Shout you all out. Thank you all for supporting the platform, supporting the podcast, and it is all powered by KingCode.com. Make sure you log on to KingCode.com. Push the culture over on that side. You dig? Okay. All right.
I will say, for y'all to look out, the cloth masks apparently are not going to be good enough to get on planes. So far, the European government and some of their airlines are not allowing a cloth mask on the airplanes. They want you to have N95 mask or some
the
type
hell?
Of yeah, surgical mask to get on planes. They are trying to weed out the cloth mask because they say that it's the efficacy of the mask is not.
What does that be based on, this new variant?
So yeah, that's in the European nations so far.
The vaccine thing is going too much out of control for me. I can't keep up with it. It is definitely
the story keeps changing. I don't know how many times we got to keep the story got to keep changing.
I mean, it's really crazy when you say a vaccinated person cannot donate blood or sperm. You know, like I'm gonna just let y'all marinate on that
marinate
a bit.
On that.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna say nothing else about it. I'm just saying that a vaccinated person cannot donate blood or sperm.
I'm gonna need people to stop feeding into this vaccinated versus unvaccinated shit too, though. Like we come on. We gotta get that together. We in this together. Some people would rather rely on their God-given immunity. And, you know, others would not. No, there's no judgment on either way, either which way you go. Where you go is the way that you go.
That's a fact. That is a fact. That's what we are about to keep on streaming over here on BIGO Live. So everybody that is listening to the podcast, make sure you go download BIGO Live and follow Push the Culture on BIGO Live, right? And everybody on BIGO Live, make sure you go to YouTube and subscribe to Push the Culture. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you follow Push the Culture on all platforms.
All
we're streaming
platforms.
Everywhere. Maybe it's the payback for women I took advantage of. Dope hidden in the precious flowers. She understands my love.